Hello, dear friends and followers. My name is André de Jong from Staalhamwerken. Well, I received a big box. And why? I will tell you at the moment. Big box, mailman, mailman. I was planning to do an unboxing video, but things changed a little bit. So, I have the big box. And what is in it? The content of is packing material. Packing material. Air. Packing material. Even more. It never ends. Whee! Empty box. Well, there was thankfully more in the box. I have liquid, and very special liquid. But why it's this for? Well, it is actually a sad story, because I made a small error. A week ago, I ordered new paint from a new company. I heard very good stories about it. I ordered from that company, standard Feldgrau paint. Well, darker version I'm used to. Sorry for the noises. Here you have it. From Militär Lacke Point DE, paint from Germany. Well, I ordered my other paint from eBay, but well, some say I want my helmet painted with this paint, so I ordered it. Maybe you can see it. Here it is, a very nice dark green paint. And I was like, well, very nice color. So of course I can paint it in that color, no problem. I will order the paint for you. So I can paint also equipment with this and everything. And if I prepping for painting, I dilute the paint. And I dilute paint automatically with this thinner. Well, I don't know the English word for it. Diluent, cellulose, something. Well, automatically I use this. And that was a big mistake. So, a message to my fellow restorers. Read the fucking instructions. So to prevent mistakes like me. It says, nur mit speciaal verdunnen über in English. Only with special dilute the paint. So I needed this. And some say, well, what happened? Some of you may wonder, well, André, what happened? Well, I fucked up a helmet. Well, yeah, sorry for my language, but it is the truth. Automatically, I use this one with this. So, well, I mix it and pure it in a spray gun and go. Well, you know the drill. Well, what happened? This is also, you can, well, dilute the paint with it. You also can clean equipment and the spray gun, the brushes, you name it, everything. Well, what happened? This reacted with this paint, the new brand. It dissolves or break down the paint. And I didn't realize it when it was dry. And I'm like, well, something with a very big F of fuck. Oh, well, the paint. This is normally matte paint. And, I try to show you, but what happened? It break down and it started to change of color. It became, well, maybe 3 or 4 times lighter, almost apple green on the M35 helmets. And at the matte changed into became shiny, very glossy, disappointing. I contact the client and he was like, oh, I don't mind to be signy. And I'm like, no, I have a reputation to protect. So I have to solve the problem. So what I did, I now read the instructions and find out I need a different diluent, well, liquid. And I ordered new one with some other stuff. I have new, spoiler alert, because you already saw it, a new spray gun. Whee! And what's so special? Believe it or not, this one, if I go to the local hardware store and I buy a spray gun, I pay around 35 to 60 euros for a spray gun. And this one was under the 20 euros. Whoa. And well, believe it or not, I have the same one. This model is the first one I ever bought, but this is a new one. My older one, well, the cup is almost broken off because of the cleaning. And I'm like, I paid, well, I'm not going to say that how much I paid for that one, but I found these just online for under the 20 euros. And I'm like, well, you can guess it. F me. I know this one will work. I know this one will exactly do what it will do. Will do smooth surfaces. Will accept aluminium oxide for the texture. This is a workhorse for all your things. If you restore helmets. Because there are other spray guns. And you have especially the special spray guns for cars and mopeds and classic motorcycles. Of course, you don't use a cheaper one like this. You buy an expensive one. Of course, I fully understand that. But for the helmet hobby I have, or some of you also have, this is the right tool for just, well, 19 euros 80, well, under the 20 euros. And if you have a compressor, give it a try, because when you start spraying with a compressor and spray gun, well, you're never gonna touch a spray gun again. So I was like, I fucked up a helmet. Well, I will solve it. And the helmet is something I never, no, that's not the right way to say it. I have done several German paratrooper helmets, the Fallschirmjäger helmets. I have done originals. I have reproductions, expensive reproductions, reproduction of FVA Werke, and this one I never handled, never seen one before in real life. This is a Fallschirmjäger helmet from Warheads. These are 250 UK pounds, that's around 285 euros with some shipping with it, around 300 euros. And well, it's a solid, nice shell. Yes, heavy. I like the shape of it. I cannot say something negative about this helmet. Of course, my fellow reenactors will ask, how does this one compare with the ones of FVA Werke? In my honest opinion, if you compare the shells, these are equal in quality. I don't say they are the same, but for the European reenactors, this, if you are looking for an alternative for next to an original helmet, this one will do. But this one is around 300 euros and you only have a naked shell, and you need bolts, paint, liner, chin strap, everything. And I believe, I can be mistaken, around $500, $550, you have a complete FAA worker helmet, but you have to pay shipment, and because many things are from the United States going to Europe, you have to pay import tax, import fees. It is something you can recommend. That's not the right word. Something you can consider. Do I go for a FAA worker helmet or a warhead helmet? To me, these are very, well, this one is also very nice next to the helmets made in the United States. Well, so I cleaned up most of the inside because that was all shiny because I used the wrong right word for it. Diluent liquid to dilute the paint. Well, the can with the spray gun was not the only thing in the big box. Sorry, going back to the big box from the mailman today, I got several of these. These are mixing cups for paint. These are, if I'm gonna use two component paint, I can use this. Do I need the dilute paint? I can use this. Mixing different colors, I can use this. I also have something else. I have paint filters. Well, the problem is my current stock of paint is getting older. And well, we all have experience with an old can of paint, and you have that Dutch, we say, a fleece. And I don't know the right word in English, a layer of solid stuff underneath it, and you can try to stir it, but you always have flakes in the paint, and that's annoying because the paint can be useful, but you have to filter the flakes out, and that is why I ordered several of these. Napoleon! Well, I hope I can still save a lot of paint using these filters, because otherwise I have to throw away a small portion of good paint. Some say, Andrew, it is winter, did you not store the paint right? Well, the paint, some paints are just getting too old, and I have to figure out a way to either save it or I have to throw it all away to the Dutch, we say, Milieustraat, mayor office for the chemical, small chemical waste. What do we have more to tell? I sometimes sell helmets, I sometimes buy helmets, I buy helmets for a commission. I was online and I saw an advertisement, someone was looking for a helmet, and I was like, oh, I got that cell, helmet cell in stock, make some pictures, send them the PM, and let's see what happened. And he was like, yeah, that is the model I wanted, very nice one, I want it. And I was like, that weekend going to my girlfriend, and I say, well, you live in a neighborhood of my girlfriend, I will drop by. And well, he offered me a helmet, so we did I traded in a helmet from him, and what did I get in return? An ET66 M42 helmet and solid cell. Sadly enough, a little bit of rust damage, but it needs some filler, but that can be fixed. It is a hard solid cell. This is gray primer. The previous owner sprayed it on it to conserve the helmet in his storage, and well, I will just brush some chemical chemical paint stripper on it, and it will solve. It will become a naked helmet again. Do I have more to say? Oh, at the moment I have one under the workbench. I have an M40 SA66 helmet. It will become a hair single decal helmet. It was a rusty bucket, needed some hardware tools to remove the rust. I should be considering to invest into a sand blasting Kemet, but I don't have the money and the space for that. So I use some, what's the right word for it? Some heavy tools to sand, to remove the most of the rust, and I need a lot of filling to do. So that helmet needs a lot of TLC, well, you know what that stands for, total love and care. But I will fix it, I can fix it, and I will turn it into a nice helmet again. I have done rusty buckets before, so it will be done. It only will take some time. Well, that was the video for now. The main message was to my fellow restorers. Read the fucking instructions to prevent errors. Thank you. I hope you enjoyed this video. See you next time.